was an especially exciting one. Perfect for a penny dreadful.
A famous professor dies twice.
That's once more.
It's so very awful. The professor died of an heart attack just days ago. Then tonight, I hear pounding at the door. I open it to find him bleeding and in pain. He tried to say something, then collapsed dead. Again. He kept repeating, Barkesso, Barkesso, over and over. What does it mean?
It's unthinkable. Such a great man. We were still in mourning from the burial. He was buried yesterday in the family plot.
I believe I should re-interrogate a suspect. Well now, I didn't ask about this. I should go back and ask about this.
My father was an eminent anthropologist and something of an explorer. He made his name by investigating the practices of a small village in the Congo. His colleagues at the university often sent him trinkets from abroad. This is no time to talk about the will. It is true that my father and my fiancée didn't get on, but I'm confident that once he got to know her as a daughter-in-law, they would have become friends.
Spider? Let's get that out of here. Emmett is definitely afraid of spiders. He got that a few days ago. Inside was a statue. I thought it was a marvel. But he told me it was quite common. I don't know who sent it.
Oof.
should go back and ask about what I've heard. I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
He showed up again. First time that's happened in 35 years of grave digging. It's plain that 7 guineas is a lot for a bloke like me. I'm careful with me pennies and save for a rainy day. I saw the sun lock a tomb myself. I saw the sun.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this. I wonder if someone could tell me more about this. I believe I should reinterrogate a suspect.
The anthropological sciences have lost a great mind. He revolutionized the field. It is my fond hope that I may inherit his mantle. Which one is that? Sorry, difficult to read. I've lost my spectacles somewhere. I recently traveled to Africa in order to continue studies on the indigenous tribe Professor Bing discovered some time ago.
An eminent colleague. He wrote prolifically. Probably no one will ever amass the amount of knowledge he acquired. I'm most vexed about that. A rare specimen of the sort I've been studying for years. It escaped a few days ago, no doubt due to that scatterbrained assistant Virginia. My thesis subject. My South American colleagues tell me that this particular arachnid is only found in the Bolivian Andes. Fascinating subject.
A lovely man, and quite wealthy. I only wish he had lived to bless my alliance with his son. Yes, that's mine. I misplaced a similar one, possibly at the funeral. I was so upset. I'm sorry to hear about that. Do you know whether that change was actually made? I hoped you wouldn't find that. I'm afraid several of the faculty purchase cadavers for research purposes. It's a fact of university life.
Body snatching? That's an insult. I'd be in the slammer quick as that if I got caught. So I sell a body or two on the side. A man's got to eat, ain't he? I broke the lock and left him on a barrow just behind his tomb. It was dark, couldn't really see. But some fella come by and carted the old professor off. It's muddy back there. You can likely still see the tracks.
Thank you.
Which one is that? Sorry, difficult to read. I've lost my spectacles somewhere. I recently traveled to Africa in order to continue studies on the indigenous tribe Professor Bing discovered some time ago. The anthropological... The anthropological site...
Sorry to hear about. Yes, that's my... I hoped you wouldn't...
I saw the sun lock the tomb myself. So I sell a body. It's plain that 7 guineas is a lot for a bloke like me. I'm careful with me pennies and save for a rainy day. So I sell a body or two on the side. A man's gotta eat, ain't he? I broke the lock and left him on a barrow just behind his tomb. It was dark, couldn't really see. But some fella come by and carted the old professor off. It's muddy back there.
Thank you.
the anthropological I required his knowledge in order to become the greatest anthropologist in the British Empire, and his beloved tribe of savages provided the method.
That Professor Silas was particularly cunning and gruesome. Mr. Raymond will be thrilled. Think of that. Crushed by a crate. The most hated man in...
Can you imagine achieving such a title? One day my brilliance will bring me similar recognition.
I know the man. He's hated by everyone. Surprisingly, it's not clear what killed him. I find multiple wounds. No need to send many people to jail for killing such a terrible man. What say you only arrest the single person who actually caused his death? He appears to have been stabbed with a perforating weapon, perhaps a spike of some kind. There would be bleeding and it would affect motor control right away, but death wouldn't come for another 6 minutes.
I suspect that there is at least one deadly toxin in his system.
Thank you.
He's my husband. Each day I bring him the household expenses just after he eats his apple. I also brought him his invitation to the knighthood ceremony, the one with the special scepter. Of course, he wasn't going to take me along. I often tie up my hair around a knitting needle. What business is it of yours?
He stopped by here every day at the exact same time. He'd buy an apple and tried to cheat me out of tuppence. But then most folks do that.
Stops in front of this pub every afternoon to check on business rumors. Something of a bastard, Ashton. Told me he had a bit of jam on the side, if you know what I mean. Wife didn't know about it. Well, the bit of jam wants out, but he won't let her. That's the sort of fellow we're speaking of.
I should return and find out about this.
That was Ashton's doing. The man had it in for me. He paid workers to wreck my machines. Cost me a fortune. As long as he was around, I'd never prosper. As a matter of fact, I do carry a revolver at all times. It can be a dangerous neighborhood for a wealthy fella such as myself. This proves nothing.
To me for years. He arrives precisely at 1 o'clock and leaves 2 minutes later. He takes a bluish medication every day and prefers that I administer it. Mary is a trusted assistant. As far as I know, she's completely above board. Today, she swept the shop and prepared some medications. She also fetched herself an apple from the apple stand.
I see him here every day. He can be unpleasant, but I don't really know him.
Thank you.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
This really is none of your business. He came to me for his blue medication. I gave him blue medication.
I should go back and ask about this.
He owned this site and paid us. We all hated him because he looked for any excuse to cheat us out of our wages. I didn't hate him any more or less than my mates. That's around the time I'm given a few minutes to eat something. About then I would have been buying myself an apple at the stand down the street. It's difficult to work properly. You'd have to know what you're doing to drop it at just the right moment.
I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
The right bastard. I hope he's smoldering in hell. I'm not a crane operator. I wouldn't know how to work there. My best chum is maimed for life, and Ashton didn't care a fig. He deserved what happened. Beyond that, I'm mum.
Here when we heard the crate hit the ground. Girl who works at the pharmacy? Yeah, she slipped me an extra threepence. She had a special apple just for Mr. Ashton. I gave him that one when he come by. Mr. Ashton did look strange-like, eyes all yellowish, and then he turned pale after he bit into the apple. Almost green, really.
Apple seller to give him a special apple. Is that a crime? He was a horrid man. That's all I have to say.
Taught him how to work the crane a few days ago.
Mr. Ashton did look strange-like.
Very well. I found out about his dalliance with that girl from the pharmacy. It's not the first. Divorce is all but impossible given his influence with the clergy. I'll be the toast of the town.
A very unpleasant fellow. But what was that business about a knighthood ceremony?
Up to the clink with you!
In any case, Mr. Raymond will have a story for Purloch Publishing.